neutral side action, and we're just about set to kick off. And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Notre Dame is getting fired up down there as they get ready to boot this opening kickoff. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 24-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Under pressure, and he throws it away. From their own 24-yard line, second down. He scrambled. And down he goes at the 29-yard line.
Call it a gain of 5 yards. Third down.
Hands. So that'll make it fourth down.
On third down, the defense was expecting the pass, and they defended the play very well in the secondary.
They've got 10 guys up. They're coming after the kick. He makes it out to midfield. Pretty good job by the return man there. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. Looks middle, got his back. He's brought down in the open field. So a nice little pitch and catch there, and that'll give the offense a first down.
That was a very good-looking pass play to get more than enough yards to move the chains.
Quick to an open man, he dropped it. From the 32-yard line, it's second down. He's at the 20. He's taken down right around the 14-yard line. And the tailback broke that one for a very nice game.
Give the offensive line some kudos there. They blocked very well up front to create the holes for this back.
At about the 13. He keeps it and picks up maybe a yard. Zips it to the back. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
Now this comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver, and the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
He's tackled at the 2-yard line. They bring him down in the backfield.
Ouch. Pretty big loss on the play, and I think they might want to reassess the strategy here. Perhaps run a screen, maybe hit the tight end on a short pattern. This D-line is just a bit much to handle at this moment.
Fourth down. This one should be makeable. Notre Dame could take the lead with this field goal. He gets it up, and he's got it.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Taken from the 3-yard line. And he's tackled at the 25-yard line. Notre Dame's looking right now like they've got all three phases working for them so far, Kirk.
Yep, it's early, but they are in control of this game. The defense seems to have a very good feel for what they're doing out there. The offense moved the ball down the field. Special teams, everything right now is really in sync for this team.
And while they are behind, they know they can can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. Second down and six. Ball on the 28-yard line. And he throws it away. There's a strike complete. And they make the stop at the 36. From their own 36-yard line. First down. Here's the tight end. Dropped.
I love to see a confident quarterback. But you don't want to just go back there and put blind faith into your throws. You need a little bit more time to evaluate the coverage before you release the football.
Screen pass. He's got his halfback.
Successful offenses always get the ball into their playmakers' hands however they can. The screen play is certainly one of those ways to accomplish that.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 46-yard line. Under heavy pressure. And he's hit before he can go anywhere.
He made a really good move at the line of scrimmage. Sometimes all you need to do is throw off the defender's timing just a little bit at the start of the play.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. From the 11-yard line, it's first down. Let it go, and it's caught for the touchdown.
I like how the quarterback, the offensive line, and the receivers made a concerted effort to get into the end zone.
And he adds the extra point. A 9-play, 75-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school, grind it out and earn the yards and just rip the heart right out of that defense.
He'll return it from the 3. At the 30. He's taken down at the 38. You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Caught, open field. They'll bring him down at about the 49. Good open field tackle.
That brings him second and 9.
Gets it. He's in space. And he's tackled around the 21-yard line. push him out at the 13-yard line. Nice play to set up first and goal.
They're eating up a lot of field on this drive. I'm really impressed with their ball control. A run all the way. Got a good jump. Once he got there, he wasn't about to let him slip away either.
Second down, goal to go. Ball on the 3-yard line. Now we'll see how the backup can do after that injury. Tosses it out. Touchdown, Irish. So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a 3-point lead with this extra point. He makes the PAT. A 7-play, 63-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown. So the score now, 10-7.
Kirk, we saw this guy head to the locker room a little bit earlier. Good to see him back on the sideline, and it looks like he could be returning to the game.
He's to the 20. He wasn't breaking that tackle. What a hit.
I think this defense right now needs somebody to try to lift up their spirits. They seem to really be just out there kind of going through the motions. And I think the last time they were out there where they gave up such a long drive has had an impact and effect negatively on the psyche of this defense.
A long ways yet to go, but at the end of one, Notre Dame's got a 3-point lead.
To the action here in the second quarter. It's been a good one and a tight one at this point.
Loss of two by the halfback. We've got third and 12. Ball on the 18-yard line. Wants it all, going deep. Doesn't get there.
You got to give the receiver a chance to make the play. That was just underthrown. That makes it fourth and 12.
They'll bring him down at the 42-yard line.
Both teams are kind of struggling to take control of this game. Obviously, they're both very, very competitive with one another. It just seems that the lead is going back and forth between the two teams.
There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Throws it in a hurry. Brought down around the 31-yard line.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they looked sharp before this one even started.
Throws quick to the receiver and it falls incomplete.
You know, sometimes the toughest throws to make for a quarterback is when he has a wide receiver wide open. And everybody in the stands is saying, throw it, throw it. And you aim the football instead of just getting back in rhythm, stepping, and throwing. That time, he aimed the ball and was in control.
Notre Dame has a 3-point lead. Tries to pitch it, and now the ball is loose. And the defense picks it up. Inside the 10. Touchdown, Hawaii!
But always makes you nervous anytime a defender tries to pick up a fumble and run with it instead of just falling on it. Man, did it work out for him here for a big-time play in the score.
Converts the extra point.
yet set to kick this one away. Taken from the 3-yard line. He's tackled at the 25. Well, let's see if the offense can make up for the misfortune they had just a few moments ago.
Brad, it's very important that this offense put that last possession behind them and just focus on trying to put together some positive plays right now and see if they can put a drive together.
And down he goes at the 49-yard line.
Chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
Let's go, D.
That'll make it fourth and six. And they could really put their opponent in bad field position with a good punt here. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Hawaii is up by 4. And he's got it. And they finally push him out at the 46. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 46-yard line. Defense goes with the extra defensive backs as the offense comes up 5 wide. He's taken down at the 45.
That'll make it second and inches.
Around the 40-yard line.
Number 13 wins his battle.
From the 40-yard line. First down.
First and 10.
Empty backfield. Quarterback in the gun. 5 wide receivers. Oh, and he had some steam on that throw. He's tackled at the 24-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 24-yard line. Caught out of the open. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal.
Gain of 15 yards. That makes it first and goal.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Hawaii holds a 4-point lead. He gets out to about the 9-yard line, and the halfback's got nowhere to go. The Warriors had one of their key guys go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to return. Runs it right. Nice pickup. Here we go, folks. Third and goal from the 4. And on the throw, he caught it. And he's taken down
right around the 4-yard line.
Not a lot on that one.
The defense respects this guy and knows they have to pay a lot of attention to him. He didn't have any room after that catch.
Thank you.
Kicks away, and it's through the uprights. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Caught at the 8. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 24.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
Five wide. And he almost has the INT.
Man, I don't know if this quarterback misread the defense or just made a poor decision. But that wasn't a pass he should have thrown.
Second down, 10 to go.
Ball on 24. The stop at about the 31. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. Inside the 30. Knocked out of bounds around the 16-yard line.
So the big gain resulting from the pass play leaves us with a first and 10. Complete. He's got room.
Tackle made at the 12-yard line.
Everything about that play was crisp. The route, the throw, the catch. That's fun to see.
One-yard loss.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
So with a half ending, they're just going to try to put 3 points up on the board. Kicks up, and it's good. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Fielded at the 4. Tackle at the 28. So at the end of the half, the Warriors lead 17-13.
Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half.
He'll return it from the 6. He makes it to the 25-yard line. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing.
He makes it out to about the 27-yard line.
They'll knock him down for a loss. From their own 24-yard line, third down.
Delivers to the halfback on the screen. He's knocked out of bounds around the 34-yard line.
He gets out to about the 38-yard line. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Hawaii is up 4.
catches it, and he's looking for more. They'll bring him down right around the 34.
That makes it first and 10.
From the 34-yard line, first down. They come out in a five-wide set. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete. And he's got all the time in the world. Caught with room to work. Huge gain, and that sets him up nicely with a first and goal. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Touchdown, Warriors. Nice time to use the fullback there.
I've always liked when teams mix it up and give the fullback the ball in goal line situations. If the big bruiser can't get you a couple of yards, you don't deserve to get in.
And he tacks on the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Down he goes at the 20-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. And they'll get him in the backfield. And he's tackled at about the 33-yard line. And he jumped out of bounds around the 38-yard line. Midfield makes it to the 47.
That's a gain of one on the play. That makes it second and eight.
Throws in the middle, brought down right around the 44-yard line. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 37. He heaves it deep. He gets another, and this is a big one.
Out here truly knows what he has to do to contribute to make his team successful.
The coverage just couldn't keep up with him there. And he adds the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff.
He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 27-yard line.
Kirk, if this keeps going like it has been, we are going to have one exciting fourth quarter.
I just hope we continue to see this kind of execution. It's a lot of fun to be able to watch these offenses make plays, and it kind of has that feel. Whoever does have the ball last and a chance to make a play could win this game.
Six points and a pretty display of passing was a result of their last drive. Kirk, do you expect the defense to take a different approach here?
When this quarterback is on, he is on. It already seems like whatever this defense is trying just isn't working. But maybe if they add just a little bit more pressure, then they might be able to force him into a mistake.
From their own 30-yard line, second down, Hawaii is up by four. Tackled after a decent pickup.
Gain of seven on the play. That'll bring up third and inches.
Two tights, two tights.
Throws complete. He's got space to work. And down he goes around the 41-yard line. From their own 41-yard line, it's first down. And he just gets rid of it. Chucks it downfield. And he snags that one. He's pushed out of bounds around the 3-yard line. And the big pickup through the air has made it first and goal. To the receiver, got it for the touchdown. And so he found his receiver for the score.
And the closer you get to the end zone, the more difficult it becomes to throw the football because the field becomes much smaller to work with. But they did a very nice job there to come up with the touchdown.
He makes the PAT. They line up to kick this one away. Taken from the 3-yard line. And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line. This offense threw the ball extremely well on their last drive, and they ended up with a touchdown.
This offensive coordinator's got to be feeling so good about the execution that he's seeing from his quarterback and his wide receiver. Because, again, they put so much time in trying to put a plan together. And to be able to see that actually come into play makes you feel pretty good as a play caller.
Slings it. He's taken down at the 30. They gained 5 yards there.
You don't have to go deep every play to be successful. They got 5 yards on the play, and that's always a good game.
One more quarter to play, and now they're just trying to hang on. 31-20, Warriors. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. Six-yard line. run there. This is the ninth play of this drive.
That makes it second and six.
Mike three. Fumble.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Inside the 10. He's tackled around the 7-yard line.
Tell you, that's not an easy thing to do there. The defenses nowadays are so tough when you get inside the red zone.
So the kicker's going to stay on the sidelines. These guys will try for a two-point conversion. Goes for the touchdown, and it's going to be an interception. So an 11-play, 74-yard drive. But the failed two-point conversion keeps it a six-point score.
You know, Brad, a lot of times you have to watch practice and watch a 7-on-7 drill to not see the ball touch the ground. But this time, they went the entire length of the field. The ball never touched the ground. Great execution by the quarterback and the receiver.
Tackle made at the 21. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. From their own 33-yard line, first down. Immediately tackled. Across the middle, tight end's got it. They pick up good yardage that time on the pass play.
Here they kind of put pressure on the quarterback and challenged him to find the hole in the defense. And in this case, he did. Nice job.
Just under three to go in regulation.
You got to love this quarterback-receiver combo. Talking to these guys before the game, they told me they spend about an hour after every practice perfecting the routes. It sure shows.
And he's taken down at the 49. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
Throw, and they make the
stop at the 34-yard line.
He's hit the 300-yard mark with that throw.
You can tell the quarterback's done a really good job of preparing because he's read the defense like a pro all day long.
Taken down in the backfield. From the 36-yard line, it's second down. Gets out to around the 28.
That's a gain on the play. That'll bring up third and four.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. A quarterback in the gun with five receivers. To the receiver, and he's got it again. Tackle made right around the 22-yard line.
I thought there was a chance he'd be brought down before getting to the marker. It was a great effort there to get beyond for the first down.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. So this one goes final. A hard-fought, close game. 31-26, Warriors. That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.